Hello and welcome. My name is Naomi Gottlieb-Miller, a Conscious Healthy Mama. Today we're going to twist. So for a moment, just start with your eyes closed. Rest your hands on your thighs. Sit up really long and tall. Make sure that your hips are heavy on the floor and that your head is resting right at the top of your spine and in line with your hips instead of forward of them. Now I know that the whole point of YouTube is to be able to see, to watch these videos with your eyes open. But for the moment, keep your attention more inward. Twisting is a much more internal experience. The idea of twisting is to move from the inside out instead of moving your outer body and hoping that your inner body will come with you. So for our first twist, I want you to tap into that inner body intuition. Intentional movement from within. Just keeping your eyes closed, bring your left hand to the outside of your right knee. Walk your right fingertips behind you just a little bit. Now press into your right fingertips, lengthen up through your spine, and twist very gently your belly, your ribs, and from left to right, your chest. Keep your hips stable, and use your fingertips, your right fingertips on the floor, as a guide so that you can be more sensitive with your twist. And inhale, come on back through center. Walk your left fingertips over to the left and behind you, right hand to the outside of your left knee. Now very gently pull against your left leg with your right hand and press your left fingertips into the floor to help lengthen you up through the crown of your head. And as you twist, if you feel like you're wrenching from your shoulders, back off a little. Breathe into the back of your body, breathe into the sides of your body. Send your breath across your chest and twist from right to left. From bottom to top. Inhale, come on back to center. And you can go ahead and open your eyes. But keep that intuitive movement throughout your practice. Extend your legs out in front of you. Okay, continue to sit up really long and tall through your spine as you bend your right knee and cross your right foot over your left knee. Take a hold of your right shin with your hands so you can interlace your fingers and pull your shin towards your body, but at the same time pull your torso towards your shin so you lift yourself up a little bit more. And take your left hand around your right calf muscle, walk your right fingertips to the right again, and gently twist. And use your breath to move from the inside out. So you're trying to move from the lowest part of your torso up through the highest, kind of on the diagonal. So from the lowest part of your belly on the left side all the way up through your right shoulder. And take a full breath in. And out. And then inhale to bring yourself back to center and switch legs. Extend your right leg straight out. Bend your left knee in. Cross your left foot over your right knee and hold on to your left shin. You can interlace your fingers to give yourself a better grip. Pull your shin towards you as you lengthen up through your spine. And keep as much of that length as you can as you hold on to your right or your left calf muscle with your right hand. Walk your left fingertips to the left. Press down into the earth as you stretch up through your spine and gently twist. And use this resistance. If you pull on your calf muscle, it'll fire up your biceps. Bonus. That also gives you a little bit more spaciousness across your chest so you're not twisting from your shoulder. Keep your chest open, your shoulders broad. Full breath in, full breath out. And then inhale, come on back to center. And come up to stand, a wide-legged stance. So step your feet out wide and fold forward. Okay, take a full breath in here, full breath out. And now walk over towards your left foot, turn your left foot towards the front edge of your mat, lift your right heel up so that you're in a lunge. And now you can keep your right knee lifted or put your right knee down, but bring your left hand to your left thigh. And if you can, stay up on your fingertips. It just gives you a little bit more sensitivity so that you're not locking out your balancing arm. Okay, you don't want to lock out your arm. That's going to make it a lot harder to twist. So if you can, be up on your fingertips. If not, have a light touch on the floor. Press your left hand into your left thigh and use that pressure to twist your belly without taking your arm and your shoulder with you. So stay sensitive through your right arm. Press your left hand into your left thigh and turn, again, diagonally across your body from the right side of your belly up through your left shoulder. Extend your left arm up. Full breath in. You're going to exhale, lower your left hand down. Step your right leg up to meet your left into a forward bend. Inhale fully. Exhale, left leg back into a lunge. Now again, you can lower your left knee down if you like, or keep it lifted. This time we'll keep it lifted. And if you feel like you're getting stuck over your right leg, just bring your right arm to the inside of your right leg. The hand's not going to stay on the floor anyways. Just give yourself more space. Okay, stay up on your left fingertips if you can. Right hand to right thigh and push. And as you push your hand into your thigh, that'll give you a lift through the left side of your belly. It'll help you open through the left side of your chest. Extend your right arm up. Inhale fully. Exhale, lower your right hand to the floor. Step up again into a forward bend. Inhale here. Exhale, right leg back. Put your right heel on the ground and walk your hands diagonally out away from your body. You know, press through your right foot and lower your hips down. It's really important to keep your right leg steady as you stretch out. Okay, now walk back. Walk to center, turn your left foot in. Place your left hand in between your legs, right about at the center and right out in front of you. Right hand to your hips, and in particular, right above your butt crack, right on your sacrum, right above your butt crack. Okay, it's a flat part of your low back. Now, if you press with that spot, you want to make sure that it's not tilted one side to the other. It's just going to give you a little bit of reference. And keep your hips level, turn your body to the right, towards your right foot. Keep your left shoulder back, your hips even, and extend your right arm up if you can. If not, just bring your hand to your hip. Okay, full breath in. And exhale, lower your right hand down. Turn your right foot out and walk your hands out diagonally away from your hips. Wipe your nose on your arm if you have a little bit of a cold, no problem. I learn all my best moves from my kids. And as you stretch out here, keep pressing back through your left leg so it's not all on the right. And then walk back in, turn your right foot in, move your right hand to the center of your mat, and in between your legs equally. Left hand to that flat spot right above your butt crack. Okay, now you're only doing that to give yourself reference to keep your hips even. Okay, without letting your hips splay over to the left, twist your body to the left, roll your left shoulder back, and either extend your left arm up or bring your hand to your hip, your left hip. Full breath in, and full breath out. Lower your left hand down. Turn your left foot out again. Okay, lift your right heel up and lower your right knee to the floor. Okay, if you need support underneath your knee, just fold over your mat or put a blanket there. But take your right elbow to the outside of your left knee. Left hand on top of your right. Now push your left hand down into your right hand. And as you do that, push your right foot into the floor. Okay, the more you push down, the easier it is to twist. Right, it gives you so much more leverage. Inhale fully here. Exhale completely. And take one more full breath in, maybe even gaze up towards the ceiling. And then exhale, unwind. Okay, shift your hips back. Curl your left toes away from the floor. Straighten your left leg. As you curl your toes away from the floor, give yourself a squeeze. So pull from your heel up towards your hip, and you'll feel your hamstrings engage. Excellent. Inhale fully. Exhale completely. Okay, take one more full breath in here. As you exhale, rebend your left knee and lower your forearms to the floor. Now, if only one forearm comes to the floor, it should be this right forearm. You can pop up onto your left fingertips because we're going to twist here anyway. Keep your back toes curled under to protect your right knee. Left hand to your left thigh and push. Now, be really mindful. You're not trying to widen your knee out to the left. So you have to resist with your left thigh. That'll allow your body to twist a little bit more easily. Okay, take a full breath in, pushing against your thigh. Full breath out. Extend your left arm up. Squeeze your legs towards one another. Just a little more juice to twist. And then lower your left hand down. Okay, step your right leg forward and your left leg back. Okay. Bring your arms to the inside of your right leg. Lower your left knee down. And then bring your left elbow to the outside. So your right knee, left elbow, right knee. Right hand on top of left. Okay, and push down. Okay, as you push down, you'll feel a lift through the left side of your belly, which is exactly what you want. Okay, that lift gives you more space to twist. Okay, the more you push your right hand down into your left hand, the more movement you will have. Help yourself out by pushing through your left foot as well. Okay, full breath in, full breath out, maybe even look up towards the ceiling. See what's happening up there. And then very carefully, unwind. Shift your hips back as you curl your toes away from the floor. Now it's back, but not down. So you want to keep your hips lifted so your left leg, which is your back leg, is more vertical, or the thigh is vertical. Okay, curl your right toes away from the floor and pull from your heel up towards your hip. So you feel your hamstrings working for you. Okay, take a full breath in, full breath out. One more full breath in. As you exhale, re-bend your right knee, arms to the inside of your right leg, and lower your forearms down. And if only one of them comes down easily, it should be your left one. Pop up onto your left finger, your right fingertips, because you're going to be twisting here anyway. Keep your back toes curled under because it'll take the weight out of your knee, okay? Especially if you're pushing powerfully into your toes and the ball of your foot. Bring your right hand to your right thigh and push. So again, you're not trying to open your thigh out to the side, push down. So that you can lift up through your belly and twist. Okay, as you twist, turn your chest up towards the ceiling. Twist a little more. Keep pulling up and extend your right arm straight up. Full breath in. Full breath out. And then lower your right hand to the floor. And step left foot up to meet your right into a forward bend. With your feet about hip width apart. Full breath in. Full breath out. Take your left hand to the outside of your right shin. Walk your right fingertips out in front of you. Okay, now, if your legs are not straight with your knees bent, just give yourself a block or a water bottle, something to lift yourself up, or you can just keep your knees bent. That's also fine. But pull with your left hand on your right shin. Pull, like you're trying to pull this right leg over to the left more. But resist against it as you twist. Full breath in, full breath out. So you gotta really work your arm here. Your biceps are engaged again. That's a good thing. Full breath in, full breath out. Good, one more time. Full breath in, make space. Full breath out. And then unwind carefully and switch sides. Right hand to the outside of your left shin and pull. Now as you pull, your right leg has to pull towards the left. Otherwise, you're just gonna fall over. Okay, so pull firmly with your right hand against your left shin, but stabilize with your right leg as you twist. Walk your left hand out in front of you, bend your knees if you need to, but press into the floor with your fingertips as you pull your belly and chest through. Inhale fully. Exhale completely. Good, one more full inhale. And full exhale. And then inhale back to center. Big breath in, big breath out. Okay, step back, downward facing dog. Pedal your feet just a little bit. And then lower your knees to the floor. Coming into table pose. Take this left hand and your arm, thread it underneath your right. Again, pop up onto your fingertips. So again, always best to be on your fingertips, particularly when you're twisting, because it gives you a little bit more space, more mobility, more sensitivity. Remember that twisting is all about sensitivity and intuitive movement, intentional internal movement. All of the eyes. How much alliteration can we get into one class? Press your right fingertips into the floor and use that to twist your belly and chest through. And if you want to open up more space, extend your right leg straight back. Walk your right arm a little bit more over to the left, and that'll open up more space for you. But the balance becomes a little funny. It just depends on what you want. Oh, and then walk your hand back in, slide your knee back in, and slide your left arm out. And then take your right hand, slide your right arm underneath your left, pop up onto your left fingertips. Press into your left fingertips so that you can move more of your torso through with sensitivity. And you can stay here or extend your left leg back and walk your left arm a little bit more overhead, a little bit more to the right. Full breath in. Full breath out. And then very carefully walk back in, slide your left knee in, unwind, shift back, child's pose. And then come on back up to sit. And extend your legs straight out in front of you. Okay? Cross your left foot over your right knee. Okay, wrap your right elbow around your knee. Now this might be a good place to be, or since we've done a fair amount of twisting, hook your right elbow to the outside of your left knee. Okay? Now if that feels good, you can stay here. If it feels like you're wrenching too much in your shoulders, just slide your elbow around your knee. The twist is gonna feel awesome, no matter where you are. Okay? Press your arm against your leg, leg into your arm, and use that resistance to twist. Head goes last. Move your inner body first. Diagonal. Right to left. Full breath in. Full breath out. And if you feel pretty deeply twisted and you have space, go ahead and look over your left shoulder. On an inhale, slowly, slowly, slowly coming back to center. Switch sides. Extend your left leg out. Bend your right knee back. Cross your right foot over your left knee. Hold onto your shin. Pull yourself up, just like you did at the beginning. Hook your left elbow around your right knee and start the twist. And if that doesn't feel like enough, you want to, you know, beef it up a little bit. Left elbow to the outside of your right knee. Right fingertips behind you. So as always, use your fingertips to increase your spaciousness and sensitivity. More alliteration. Okay, also dig your left heel into the floor to help stabilize your twist so that you're not losing your anchor. Keep it. And then use your left elbow against your right thigh to turn your belly and chest from the inside out. And if you feel like you have the space towards the end of your twist, you can turn your gaze over your right shoulder. And inhale fully. Exhale completely. Inhale back to center. And then bring the soles of your feet together, Baddha Konasana. It's your last twist. It's very similar to the first one, only instead of reaching for your knee at first, you're going to start with your feet and then increase. So bring your left hand to the outside of your right foot, right hand to the right. It should feel a lot more spacious now. Okay, press right hand or left hand into your right foot. Use your right fingertips to prevent yourself from lunging into it, right? Stay really long and tall through the center of your body. If you want to increase it, you can bring your left hand to the outside of your right knee. You have to be careful. Okay, you don't want to pull on your knee. Just use it as a guide. But inhale back to center and switch. Start with your right hand on the outside of your left foot, because you can even press your fingertips to the floor and that'll give you more stability as you stretch up. and twist from the inside out. And if you want a little bit more, you can take your hand, and it might even feel easier to have the back of your hand, so you turn your palm out, back of your hand pressing against your leg as you twist. It's a nice hip opener too. Get all kinds of good stuff in this little practice. Get one more full inhale. Full exhale. Inhale back to center and then scoot your feet out just a little bit and fold forward. And depending on your hips, you might go really far forward. You might be able to put your forehead into that little space in between the soles of your feet. You might be more upright. You might want to wiggle like I am. Be in the place where you feel most supported. And then come on back up and come back to that very first seat that you took, that comfortable cross-legged seat or cross-ankle seat, if that's how you started. Rest your hands on your thighs, close your eyes, come back to that internal awareness. Because this is where your twists live. This is where their power comes from, so access it in this moment. And appreciate the great support that lives within you that you can't always see and you sometimes forget is there, but is the source of your greatest strength. And as you're ready, you can go ahead and open your eyes. Thank you so much for joining me today for this twisty practice. I hope you enjoyed it as much as I did. And I look forward to doing more yoga with you again soon. Thanks so much for being here. Bye.